Hey there guys, how's it going? And welcome to another episode in my ARK Survival Evolved Let's Play on the Xbox One. We're going to be doing a couple of things today. Today's plan is to actually make the Bronto platform saddle and then actually build on it as well. But I've got some things to collect to actually do that. Some of you guys said that you actually kind of want some longer episodes and you want to watch me do a little bit of farming and you enjoy the long episodes. So today I'm going to try and do a slightly longer episode. I'm going to try and get this platform saddle done and build on it all in one episode, which is going to take me a while because there's plenty of stuff I need to get. So while I'm going to go and find some trilobites, because I actually need 90 pearls, well, I need 90 more pearls. I've already got some, and the easiest way to get the pearls is to just kill the trilobites. So while I'm doing that, I wanted to let you guys know that don't forget to leave comments, guys. Don't forget to leave your comments, because before I upload every day, or before I go to record every single day, I always check the comments section. Hold on, here's a thingy. And that helps me decide what I'm going to do that day. So it's very easy to persuade me, guys. Just leave some comments down below of what you'd like to see me do in the next episodes, and I'll get that done for you. It's not a problem. And I saw the Bronto platform saddle comment. I thought, you know what? I did actually promise that earlier, and so I'll look into that. Now, I do also have quite a few of you... Get out of here, son. I have quite a few of you asking about the raft. You're struggling to build the rafts to the size that I built mine. Very, very simple, guys. If you just look back through the episodes, I'm sure I build the raft in one of the episodes. If not, I'm going to actually build on the Bronto platform saddle, which is basically the same thing. It's like the platform saddle. The platform on the raft is just like the platform on the Bronto saddle. So I'll be able to show you guys how I do it. Did I just see one of these things? No, that's just a rock there. So don't worry, guys, I'll do that today. If you're still having trouble building your rafts on Xbox, just let me know and I'll dedicate a quick bit of a beginning of an episode to how you actually do it. So at the moment, we're looking for these trilobites, which will give us pearls. I believe you can get pearls from down in the ocean as well, but I've never actually done that. I've never actually gone and looked for that. We should do that. If I can't find enough just by going up and down here, I will do that. But it's quite easy to actually just kill these trilobites and get pearls from that. The only problem is that I need a lot of them. And maybe I'll even tame something on the way. You guys know I need to tame a lot of things to get that Bionic Rex skin. Well, I actually need to tame everything to get that Bionic Rex skin. Honestly, not sure how realistic that is. Taming some of these things in this game solo is so difficult. If you thought trying to tame a Quetz solo was tricky, wait till you try and tame a Giga or a freaking Mosasaur solo. That is a serious business. This thing's getting kind of tired. I don't know if I should just run and let him follow me or what. So the sun's about to set today. I've actually been farming out for the full day almost, and I haven't quite managed to get enough pearls, I believe. Let me just do a quick check. Teddy here has been helping me out, saving me if I get too far in the water. Let me have a little check how many pearls I've got. I've got 87. Oh, that's more than I thought. Okay. I actually only need about 10 or 20 more, I believe. So let us go and find that Teddy. Let's go off. If you're wondering why I called a wolf Teddy, it's because my actual dog's called Teddy. But my dog looks nothing like a wolf. I'll put it that way. He's just a little small dog. He's fun, though. Oh, trilobites. More trilobites here. Here we go. I should actually just go down to the surface and get pearls, but this will be fine. Go down to the floor of the sea and get some pearls. But we're nearly there now. There's five. I think... Oh, God, I can't... I need to go underneath. The reflection of the water's too hard for me to see. Right, where are they? Where are they? Where are they, Ted? There's one over here. Let's get him. Let's get him. There we go. You cannot escape, trilobites. You will be mine. Right, here we go. And are we going to get anything from him? Sometimes they don't actually give you pearls, which kind of sucks. There's another five. This might be enough, but let's just get one more so I can be sure. Oh, here he is. One more. Right, and then I'm pretty sure I've got enough pearls to make the Bronto platform saddle. Right, two. I guess that will do. Right, Teddy, let's go. Let us go back. He's a bit slow at the moment. He's a bit overweight, Teddy. Been feeding him too much. Too much of that prime meat. Oh, here's another one. Why not? Just for luck. Let's have some of this. Now, if you're wondering why I'm using the hatchet and not the pick to do this, it's because you always use the hatchet to get the secondary resource from an animal. And normally, the primary... Actually, you use it to get... Whatever isn't meat, basically, that you want from an animal, you use the hatchet to get it. So, yeah, the hatchet normally gets the primary resource. Ah, there's another one. And the pick gets the secondary resource. So I told you guys that before in last of my videos, but some of you might not have seen that one. So for instance, if you want to get thatch from a tree, you'd use a pick instead of a hatchet. But if you wanted to get wood from a tree, you would use the hatchet. And it's the same for like the secondary stuff from Dino. So if you want to get hide or chitin or pearls from a dead animal, you always use the hatchet. Oh look, there's an egg here. This is not a fertilized one, so we're just gonna eat this for some nourishment. Where's the frickin'? Here we go. Just delicious Rex egg. Right, that was your plant to eat. I'm hoping for an egg soon from my sabers because I've set them on wandering, and hopefully they're gonna make some magic happen back there. Wanderer Rousmi's back there as well. I think maybe she wants to get involved. And I thought I could breed my T-Rexes as well. I would quite like to get a higher level Rex to breed with another one though. I think DJ Khaled, I think he's got what it takes really. Right, so let's stop him following me. We're gonna need hide and fiber, even if we've got enough pearls, but I can get those very quickly. Oh, over 100. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have enough. Let's pop the pearls in there. Bronto platform saddle. Whoa, we need two more pearls. What a pain. Right, we need a lot of hide as well. Right, two more pearls. All I needed was one more trilobite and I would have had enough. Right, okay, Teddy, we're back. This is kind of frustrating though, because I'm pretty sure I cleared out the whole coast of trilobites. So finding more might be tricky, but you never know. Maybe it's my lucky day. I jump off my wolf and right here. No, it's not my lucky day. No trilobite. Okay, never mind. It's just to go down the coast a little bit. I guess this gives me a chance to go out and get some hide as well, because we need hide. And I don't think I've actually got a lot in base. Maybe there's a trilobite around here. Let's have a little look. Just need one more. One more trilobite. I see one over here. I bet he doesn't give me any pearls. I bet you he doesn't give me any pearls. I need two, guys. The dream. Give me two pearls. If he didn't give me any pearls, I'm really mad. Yes, six pearls. Beautiful. Right, now we need hide and fiber. Well, that's pretty easy to get. I bet the wolf's got a bit of hide in him, actually. I killed a couple of things, but I think you need quite a lot of hide. I think it said over 500 hide for the Bronto platform saddle. Do you know, actually, I haven't actually checked on my Bronto in a while. Hope he's okay. Okay, we've got 200 there. We've got 40 on us. That's 240 plus another 70. So we're on like 300 plus. So we need another 200 hide. Should not be an issue. We just need to go in and kill some stingers. The bigger, the better. Actually, let's just get rid of this dodo. I wonder how much hide we'll get from this dodo. So for those of you wondering on my single player settings, some of you have been asking, damn, 50 hide from a dodo. Single player settings, you've been asking, I've got it on 6x gather, which is obviously going to be a good idea because I'm trying to farm for you guys. And I want to farm as little as possible and explore as much as possible. So I've got it on very high gather rate. Although, to be honest, on the server I play on PC, I have it even higher than that. I think I can take on this Ankylo with this bad boy. You've got what it takes, right? Right, Ted? Right, so now we're on about 400 hide, so just need another 100. He's got pretty high melee damage. You should be able to get rid of this Ankylo. You've got to be careful of the Ankylos because they've got very high melee themselves. Right, okay, we've got another 100. So I think we're going to be all right. And Teddy's very slow. He's a bit overweight. Let me take some of this stuff off here and drop those spears. Yeah, right. All right, Ted, let's go. Back to base. I'm not sure if this is faster than me walking. This looks like roughly about the same speed that I run. So maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Ed in you. My Bronto platform saddle is going to be pretty epic, boys. Not going to lie. And grills, if there's any grills watching. Yeah, it should be pretty cool. Take him up the mountain. Put that platform saddle on. And we can actually farm really easily with him as well. I'm going to show you guys that. Should be pretty cool. Right. Let's put the hide away. Hide. Hide, hide. Oh, it's called hide. Maybe it likes to hide from you. Right, now we just need fiber. Oh, and the pearls, of course. And I definitely have the fiber because I stocked up on fiber with Ronda Arouse Me. I've got a fiber chest around here somewhere. Is it this one? It's not this one. It's this one. Here we go. Saying that, I have been digging into this. I'm going to have to replace some of this pretty soon. 571. I think that's enough. Let's go do this. Now, if you do this while you're playing with people, make sure you have people near you and that they get on their teams while you're doing this, because you get a lot of XP for making a Bronto platform saddle. Here we go. Bronto platform saddle being made. It's going to be pretty epic. Let's get the other saddle off of the Bronto we've got. I'm going to want to increase his weight, actually, because he's going to be carrying a lot of stuff. So let's do that. Let's drop all of these berries. He doesn't need any right now. It's a shame, actually. We colored the old one. We've got a nice pink saddle here, but that's fine. Maybe we'll color the other one when I've got a bit more time sometime. But in this same episode, I want to actually build on the platform saddle as well. So I haven't got too much time to mess around. Here we go. Down here is... ooh, platform saddle. These are so cool, guys. You can actually get platform saddles for quite a few dinos. The bigger ones, basically. The Quetzal, the Mosa, the Plesio, and the Paraceratherium. That's all I can think of right now. So let's put this on. This is a pretty epic, not gonna lie. Let's jump on here. And he, oh my word, it's even more epic than I remember it. It's like, it's so cool the way it's metal as well. Look at the size of this thing. Oh my god, we're gonna have a freaking awesome base on top of this. Look at it. Just look at this thing. I've never actually built on a Bronto platform saddle before, but I've built on other ones, so I'm sure I'm gonna know what to... oh my, this is quite intimidating. I'm gonna need a lot of foundations to do this. So, let's get on with it. Let's start making some of these foundations. I don't really want to drop off of here. You can even make a cage around yourself here, guys, to protect yourself if you're playing PvP server especially. Right, we're off the Bronto. So let's get rid of anything that's really heavy, because that's gonna stop us from collecting maximum resources. I've actually got like a spare crossbow on me, which I'm not gonna need right now. I need to poop as well, so let's do that. Have we got an egg over there, boys? They haven't mated yet. I'm still waiting on that egg, guys. Still waiting on it. I'm going to be a proud Papa Jay. Well, actually, I won't be the Papa. I'll just be the person who's doing the mating. Whatever. I don't know. Right. Anyway, let's just put this oil away. I should probably put this in the fabricator, to be honest, but I don't really care right now. Put a bit of chitin away. And the rest of that, I'm just going to throw. Oh, my God. What else did I just throw that was cool? I think I threw tranks. And a crossbow. Actually, we can put the crossbow in there. That's a good idea. Right, let's put the narcotic away as well. Don't need that. Don't need this many trank arrows on me. I'm actually... yeah, I'm going to take 25. Rex bone helmet. Damn, see? Let's put this away. All right, and we're traveling pretty light right now. I've got some parachutes on me, but I kind of want some parachutes on me anyway. So we're going to have to start off with the stone foundations. I could do these wood to make it quicker, but it won't take us too long to do stone. So let's do stone. We're going to use my super duper mega awesome fast crafting technique. So yeah, I'm pretty light. This is pretty cool. Let's go. So as you guys know, I like to stock up on the wood and the thatch first. It's going to be wood, thatch and stone. So let's first of all do the thatch. Let's actually make Bob follow us. I mean, you can help us out, Bob. It's going to be a little bit shadowy right now. It's nighttime, but I've actually got nighttime going 3 times faster than normal. So it won't be nighttime for long, guys. And then we'll be back in the daytime. You can see up the mountain, it gets absolutely... holy crap, it gets absolutely freezing during the nighttime. I tell you what, how about we don't go up the mountain, Bob? Huh? How about that? A little bit dangerous. Don't really feel like taking stuff on right now. Make sure Bob's on neutral as well, so he can help me out if I've got any problems. Let's have a look. He's on... Bob, what are you on? He's on neutral. We good. We all good. Right, let's get the thatch. Get a good amount of thatch going. Beautiful. So what we're going to end up doing, I might as well tell you guys my plans while I get the wood and the thatch. Oh, jeez. We've got rid of all the freaking trees around here, Bob. Yeah, I might as well tell you my plans. I'm just going to try and make a nice big base, and I'm going to put a load of forges in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep my mate Bob up on the mountain. I'm going to fly up to him, and then I'm going to smelt the metal in the forges that are on his back. It's a fantastic thing to do. And it should make my life a lot easier. Right, I need some stamina. Quickest way to regen stamina is to lie down, by the way, guys, if you didn't know that. So that's a nice little MLG tip. God, full of tips for you guys. But like I say, while you're watching this, while you're chilling, if you haven't already, don't forget to smash the like button on these videos, especially the longer episodes. Let me know that you guys really want to see them. I should have definitely taken out another hatchet, because this hatchet is going to break in the not too distant future. Hey, don't forget to smash the like button on these videos, guys. Especially those of you that made it this far into the video. You've got to be enjoying yourself if you're this far into the video. And always, always leave some comments as to what you'd like me to do next time in Ark. Or maybe just say, Jay, I don't know what to do in Ark. Show me what to do and show me what's fun. And then I can just try and come up with something. But I'm always looking to try and give tips to people, you know. It's almost like a public service. If there's something you want to know, and I know it, I want to share that info with you. But I think there are some plans I've got. I would like to go and tame a Quetus again, but I lost my scorpion, so I need to go and get a scorpion and level it up again. And leveling things up on this is quite difficult. I've also got a server I've been playing on PC, playing PvP. If you'd like to see me PvPing on a PC server, let me know, because I do like showing you guys all the Xbox stuff. Because I know a lot of you have got Xbox, and a lot of people have searched for Xbox gameplay and found my channel. So I do obviously want to make sure that you guys who want to know all the Xbox stuff know it all. But there is some cool PvP that I'm going to be doing on PC. And I also haven't forgotten as well, a lot of you guys really enjoyed the episode where I was doing like PvP trolling. I'll try and do one of those once a week, I think. They do take quite a long time to record. It takes like a few hours of gameplay just to get like a few funny PvP moments. So they take a little bit longer to do than my Let's Plays normally. So it is a bit of an undertaking, but like I say, if you guys really enjoy those, I'm more than happy to create that style of content, because it was a lot of fun last time, and I just know how busy the servers are at the moment. It's absolutely ridiculous. So there's always going to be people on for me to go and mess about with, which is just absolutely fine with me. So foundations do actually take quite a few stone, 80 stone per one. So it's taking me a little while here to make them. I don't even know how many I've made. I should probably have a look how many I've made. I've made 10. Let's make 12, and we'll plonk them on, and we'll see how that goes. And I'll just make it in a similar vein to how I make the raft. And I think where a lot of you guys are getting stuck on the raft building is you're not putting ceilings. You're trying to add foundations, which is the only thing I could think that would stop you from being able to make the same style of raft that I make. So I will show you guys how to do that on the Boronto. Right, so we've got a few foundations here. Oh, look at the size of this platform. This is kill. Right. Let's get the foundations. Let's put them in that slot there. And okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and place it as far to the edge as possible so I can fit as much on here as I can. So kind of annoying because the Bronto actually moves. So it like, yeah, I think right, about here is going to be good. I want it so, right, okay. The only problem is I can't really see how lined up I am. I think this is pretty parallel. All right, that actually looks really good. Okay, so let's start plonking these down. So obviously I can fit a foundation on anywhere that will allow me to do this. I'm not sure if you could get four down. Why is that not connecting to that one? It's kind of weird. Oh well, let's just try and get it close. That doesn't look weird. Oh god, because it moves. Look, it moves and then it throws off where it's going. Well, oh god, Bronto, please, why do you do this? I don't know why it's not connecting to that one, actually. It should just lock on to that one. Maybe there's not enough room here. Oh, God. I've got to try and not mess this up. So let's wait till it moves up. Till it swings back up. And it should move it. Oh, God. It's being awkward. Why are you being so awkward? Oh, God. This is going to be really difficult to get it spot on. Let's see what we can do. So if it swings back up, it doesn't seem to, like, swing. That'll do for now. Now, I don't know if you can get four wide. Let's try and get four wide. So what we'll have to do is put one on the most, on the furthest edge possible. I don't think you'll be able to get four foundations on, but let's do a little bit of experimentation. Oh, gosh. Oh, no. Oh, God, this is difficult. Come on, Bronte. You got this, Bronte. Oh, careful. Right, let's see. No! Well, let me put it that far. Okay, hold on, hold on. Come get it. Right on the edge. Right on the edge. Come on. I don't think you're going to be able to get four. No, look, because this one won't. Or will it? Ooh. Kind of. You can kind of get four. Whoa, whoa, whoa. But to be honest, there's no need to have more than three anyway, so I'm just going to go for three wide. Let's do that. I think three wide looks pretty cool. And we can make some more off of the back of destroying these anyway, so let's do that. Okay, so I just want these to snap together. Don't be awkward, game, and not let me snap them together. I know you like to be awkward, Ark, but not today, all right? Not today! Right, we are looking pretty freaking smart here. Not gonna lie, we're looking pretty smart already. So obviously I can like leave a gap here for me to saddle one, or it won't matter. I might actually leave it because I think it looks better like having a little area where it's not foundation. So I'm just gonna have one more foundation and then I'm gonna start building on the back of this. Look how cool this is. It's freaking awesome. I think this is the biggest platform saddle in the game. Now I actually need to go back and get a hatchet, so I'm going to leave you right there and get myself a fresh hatchet, or just, actually you can follow me, you'll follow me, that's fine. No, leave him there, because that's where the, that's where all the stone's going to be that I'm going to want to build with. So let's go and repair the hatchet. We're going to need four ingots and four hide, or I might just go get a fresh hatchet just because it's quicker. If there is a fresh hatchet there. So this is going to be really cool. I'm going to make some forges on there. Oh, I said I'd make the ceilings as well to show you guys how wide or like how you can make it actually look bigger than it is. Oh, did I just see? Hold on. Did I just see an egg? I swear I saw something pop up. What was that? Is there a fertilized egg in here? Let's have a look. I thought I saw something red pop up. Maybe it was just the mate boosted heart. Guys, are you guys going to get it on? Come on. You're ready to mate? You're ready to mate? Come on. Let's get it on. I don't know. Anyway, we'll let them continue. Let them have some privacy. We'll get on with things. I want a little kitten, though. I want a baby kitten. So make it happen, guys. Make it happen. I don't actually have a spare hatchet, which kind of sucks. I've got loads of spare pigs, so... Let's go and repair this one. Unless there's one already in here, which would be cool. But there's not. I don't think I've got any ingots in. Oh, actually, I probably do. Right, what do I need? Oh, gosh, I need one wood. There you go. There's your one wood. Right. A fresh hatchet. And this should be good enough for us to make the rest of the platform. So we're just going to need one more foundation. Then after the foundation, we're going to go for some ceilings to show you guys how to expand the platform. And then we're going to go for some freaking walls and forges and maybe even a smithy up there. I mean, who knows? I might actually start transforming my base to metal, which would be pretty cool to be, have a little upgrade. But I think stone looks cool. I don't know about you guys. But I think stone looks a bit cooler than metal. That's just my ideas. I think it looks a bit more realistic with dinosaurs, you know, having stone around. I mean, not that humans and dinosaurs existing is particularly realistic, but you know what I'm saying. It just suits the style a little bit more. So I'm just going to stick one more foundation on here because I think it's going to look pretty cool to have like a bit of a gap. Oh, no. Oh, crap. I need three foundations. Right, I'll be back, Bronte. I need three. Not one, but three. All right, let's get the wood. And a bit more wood. What's this up here? I saw something flying. Dimorphodon. I could get a Dimorphodon swarm at some point, but I've got an awesome Dimorphodon swarm on my PvP server that I play on, so I'm actually going to show you that soon, guys. That is probably one of the craziest things I've ever done in Ark, so... Right, so we need three. We've got one. That will be two. And this will be three. Absolutely beautiful. This platform saddle looks so cool. I forgot how cool they look. And like, I haven't built on a Bronto in absolutely ages, but this is friggin' cool. Right. So let's add that. Boom. There we go. Beautiful. Boom. There we go. Beautiful. I don't know. I wonder if we could get like another foundation off the edge there. Right, okay, so you can see I've got it covered in foundations apart from this little gap. I want to have this little gap though. I don't want to be standing in a foundation. It'd be kind of awkward. So now what you do is you put ceilings off the edge, guys. I'm pretty sure this is where a lot of you are going to be going wrong on the raft in terms of like not being able to expand it like my one. So let me do this. And then hopefully with this knowledge, we all know we all like knowledge even more than Lamborghinis. Let's go and do that. Let's go and make a couple of... I mean, I don't want to build too many because I don't want like a huge, really, base on the back of it. I guess I could. I guess it would look cool. We'll see. The thing is, I don't know how much you can put on a Bronto saddle. I don't want to be limited to the amount of things I can put on because I've made the base too wide. Although I'm not going to need a ceiling on it. I mean, if you're playing PvP, you might want to put a ceiling on it and whatever, because obviously it's a bit risky just running around or like... Because I remember on a PvP server I play on, we had some guys and they had a Bronto with a platform on up a mountain and they were using it to farm. And it didn't have a ceiling on it, and we basically swooped in with birds and picked them off and then killed the Bronto. So, yeah, that's... If you're playing PvP server and you manage to get to this stage, although I've got to say I've got a few of you guys playing on the Xbox PvP servers where it's really slow gather rate and really slow leveling. But if you have managed to get to this stage where you can do Bronto platform saddles, you'll want to be putting a roof on there. And I envy some of you guys who've got like groups of friends who like to play Ark, because you can level up really quickly. And I've got groups of friends that I play PvP with, but in terms of YouTube videos, I don't really... It's a lot easier for me to record YouTube videos solo, because I don't know if you guys are going to want me to, like, be talking to all the PvP guys in the videos and whatever, but I know that you subscribed for my commentary, I guess, my tip, so that's all good. I've got to say, thanks for checking out these videos, guys, and making them kind of successful. I'm absolutely loving playing Ark. I think it's by far one of the coolest games it's been in a long time, so thanks for allowing me to spend some time doing this, because without you guys checking these videos out, I can't really do this, realistically, anyway, so thank you very much. And I'll reward you with some epic stuff, like freaking Bronto platform saddles. I mean, if you guys put the time in, I put the time in. Simple as. I'm a people pleaser. It's just what I am. I'm a people pleaser. Sounds like a new dino as well, a people pleaser. Right, let's get some more. And beautiful. How many have we got now? Let's have a little 14. We are smashing these. Episode 15 now. I don't know how many I'm gonna need. Let's just make a few more. Need some, I'm running out. Right, let's do two more. Let's get the stone here to get to this wood. Damn, it's a lot of stone. Right, here we go. Right, there's two more. Absolutely beautiful. Right, here we go. It's our... Right, so what I do is you basically hang the ceilings off of the edge of the foundations, guys. There's no other way I can think that some of you guys are having trouble with making your rafts as big as mine. But this is the same principle for rafts. It's just with Bronto platform. So here you can see, boom, off the edge. Ceilings, boys. Oops, that was a mistake. Well, I've got to freaking delete that. God damn it. It's a shame Ark doesn't give you like a chance to replace something you've accidentally placed. Like, I think it should give you a little bit of a break. We'll put these down here and here. I'm actually thinking of trying to do something really cool with this. Like, I could try and do like pillars or something. Let's hopefully I've got enough. I've got enough to do this. Oh no, it's obstructed. That's a pain in the ass. Because look, these ones overlap because this one was placed wrong. You see how this foundation is like not far enough this way? That has eventually led to that happening. So, kind of sucks. But I should be able to put a wall there anyway. Can I put a wall there anyway? No, I'm not. I'm not going to be able to. I'm going to have to replace this foundation, guys. I'm going to have to do it. Sucks. I'm going to lose all of that. Painful right there. Well, that's unfortunately the way the cookie crumbles. Right, so we're going to have to replace that. But here you guys can see, I mean, look at the size of this freaking thing already. It's absolutely epic. So let me make a foundation. Hopefully I can. I can make two. I don't know if we need three. We kind of need three here. What I think, if I can attach it to this side, that's going to solve all my problems. Okay, so I've practically made as many walls as I can carry. We might even have some spare. Oh no, I'm missing a ceiling. Oh, that's okay, we can make another ceiling, that'll be fine. But I've got more than enough walls here to see me through, so now I'm going to plop these down the outside. No need for windows or anything, I'm not that bothered. I want to feel nice and safe inside of my Bronto base, so no need for me to look out the side. I hope so anyway, but I hope this isn't going to stop me building. I think I've made this too big, we'll see. Oh god, no! Got to be careful, because the Bronto actually sways, as you can see. So sometimes you might put something down in the wrong place. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Easy, Bronto. Just taking a poop there. So this is pretty... this is a pretty substantial size platform, as you can see. I mean, pretty epic, to be honest. So we need a ceiling. And I think if I just, like, put some extras down, like, I'll get half back. There you go. I'm sure that'll be enough for me to do ceilings. Let's have a little look. There's the ceiling. We can craft one. Absolutely perfecto. Let's put this down. And I need to grab it. Build my hotbar. Replace the foundations. Not going to need that anymore. And boom. There's your ceiling right there, lad. Right. Put that down. We're going to put that down. We've got one more spare. Oh, we're missing another ceiling. Okay, hold on. Let's put this... oh, no, because then we're going to need one wall. We need that wall. Have we got what it takes to make another ceiling? Oh, what a feeling. When you need just one more ceiling. I need literally 7 stone, so... ah, bit of a pain. 7 stone... here we go. Let's get a few over here because we're going to make some forges. This is looking pretty friggin' cool. Right, let me make the ceiling. Which just down here. Craft. Oh, we can craft 2. Let's craft 1. So yeah, I'm going to actually work on this while I'm not doing a video. And I'm just going to get it to the point where I've got forges on here. I've got everything I want on here. So it's going to be really cool to show you guys. But for now, I'm just going to call this video here. This has been a long video today. It takes me a lot longer to render these long videos as well, guys. So like I said before, if you do enjoy them, don't forget to smash that like button. Oh, we can put a ceiling right there. Let's do that. Hold on. Oh my god, this is just too much. Just when I think I've done it all. Just when you guys thought you were going to get rid of me, but not yet. I'm going to put this down. Oh, that is freaking a kill. And we can put a wall there. I'm a perfectionist. I want to put a wall there. It's, okay. I guess I could not put a wall. So obviously, actually, we want a way to get off of here, don't we? Though I could actually make a ladder off the side. I could put like a ceiling on and then make a ladder so I can climb down and not lose any health. We're going to leave this like this for now. I think it looks pretty freaking cool. I don't know about you guys, but I'm really pleased with my Bronto saddle, my Bronto platform saddle. Thanks again for watching, guys. I'm going to go and expand on this now and have some more stuff to show you guys next time, as I always like to have new stuff to show you guys. And I'm out for now. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all tomorrow.